Hello students, so this is lecture number 2 of rotational motion. So in the previous lecture we had discussed about angular variables, we had discussed about angular displacement, right? Yeah, of course there are few angular variables like angular displacement, angular velocity, angular acceleration. After understanding and after knowing these terms, knowing about these terms, we can switch to other topics like torque, angular momentum, moment of inertia, of course. Fine, so in the first lecture we had discussed about angular displacement, right? Fine, let us have a fast recap. What is angular displacement? Angular displacement means it is final angle, like we had seen this. Let us say at t equals to 0, a particle is at this position, right? So this will be taken as initial angular position of the particle, initial angular position denoted by theta 1. Suppose the particle is moving in anti-clockwise direction. After any time t, let us say the particle P reaches at this point, right? So this is known as final angular position. Theta 1 is initial angular position, theta 2 final angular position, right? Okay, so what is angular displacement? It is final angular position minus initial angular position. Already we had discussed these things, right? That is theta 2 minus theta 1. Of course, angular displacement is a vector quantity whose direction can be known by right hand screw rule, and unit of theta will be, angular displacement will be radian. Okay, fine. This is just a short definition and short explanation about angular displacement. Already in the previous lecture we had discussed in detail what is angular displacement, right? Okay, so if the particle completes one complete rotation, particle performs one complete rotation, then angular displacement will be 2 pi 360. Angular displacement will be 360, 2 pi radian. Clear? Okay. Clear? Fine. So now we will understand what is angular velocity in detail, what is angular acceleration, what is the relation between linear and angular velocity. Okay. See. So angular unit of angular displacement is radian, or you can say revolution or rotation. One revolution equals to 2 pi radian. Fine. Now what is angular velocity? Angular velocity. Okay. In the chapter motion in one dimension, we had discussed about average velocity, linear velocity. Average linear velocity was defined as displacement by time, delta x by delta t. And if I am limiting the time, that means if I am applying limit to time, we will get instantaneous velocity, which was dx by dt, right? This is what we had studied in the chapter motion in a straight line. Almost analogous to this, we'll now define what is angular velocity, how to find the direction, what is the unit of angular velocity, what is average angular velocity, and what is instantaneous angular. Clear? Okay. We'll take the same case in the whole chapter. Only with the same diagram, I will explain about angular velocity, angular acceleration. Okay, see. This is the center. This is a circle of any radius r. Particle is at point A at any time t1. particle is at point A at any time t1 is a circle whose radius is r. Okay, now this particle is moving in an anticlockwise direction. After any time delta t, let the particle be at a point B at any time t2. So this is the angular displacement of the particle. This is what we had already discussed. Delta theta is the angular displacement of the particle, which the particle has gone between the time t2 and t1. That means particle took time t2 minus t1 to reach from point A to point B. So angular velocity, which is denoted by omega, is average angular velocity. This is equals to angular displacement by time. Angular displacement by time. Okay, what is angular displacement in this case? Delta theta. And how much the particle has taken the time to go from A to B? It is t2 minus t1. Let this time be denoted by delta t, t2 minus t1. So it will be delta t. So your angular velocity omega, average angular velocity, it is equals to delta theta by delta t. So what is the unit of angular velocity, angular displacement? Radian. Unit of time, second. Automatically the unit of average angular velocity or angular velocity will be radian per second. Radian per second. Clear? Done. So once again, just as in case of linear velocity it was linear displacement by time, in the same way angular velocity will be defined as angular displacement by time. So that is delta theta by delta t. Now the unit of delta theta was radian, unit of time is second. So of course the unit of angular velocity will be radian per unit of angular velocity will be radian per second. Okay, now angular velocity is a vector quantity. Angular velocity is a vector quantity. So what is the direction, how to find the direction of angular velocity? Angular velocity is a vector quantity. Direction of angular velocity can be known by right hand rule, right hand thumb rule, or right hand screw rule, whatever you say. See, how to find the direction of angular velocity, that is what we are going to understand now. Fine, but before that, this was your average angular velocity, right? Delta theta by delta t, just as this was your average velocity. This is your average linear velocity, this is your average angular velocity. Linear displacement by time, angular displacement by time. Clear? So this velocity is between two intervals, between two time intervals. Right? But if I am applying limit delta t tends to 0, that means if I am reducing the time, then I will get instantaneous angular velocity omega, which can be written as d theta by dt at a particular instant of time. At a particular instant of at a fixed or a particular instant of time, if you have been said to calculate the velocity, that will be your instantaneous velocity, right? And if you are calculating the velocity between two time intervals, like 5 to 10 seconds, 10 to 20 seconds, then that will be your average angular velocity. Of course, we will see the sums based on average angular velocity, instantaneous angular velocity, how to solve it, so you will get a perfect idea. But before that, now we will find the direction of angular velocity. Okay. Direction of angular velocity can be found by right hand rule. Suppose the body is rotating in this manner, right? Body is okay. I'll adjust according to you. Body is rotating in this manner, in this fashion. Okay, so this is anti-clockwise. This is how the body is rotating. This way. This way. Right? So the body is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Hold a screw parallel to the axis in which the body is rotating. Parallel to the axis. Parallel to this axis. Right? You have to hold a screw. Rotate the screw in the direction of the rotation of the body. Body, or you can say particle. Suppose, make it easy, a particle is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Particle is rotating this way. This is how the particle is rotating. Right? Place a screw and rotate the screw in the direction of rotation of the particle. So particle is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Rotate the screw. If you are rotating the screw in this manner, the advancement of the screw will be the direction of angular velocity. That means, in an easy manner, the particle is moving in anti-clockwise direction. Take your right hand, rotate your right hand, let your thumb remain stretched. Rotate it in a direction in which the particle is rotating, this way. Right? So this is the direction, this will be the direction of angular velocity. Right? This is right hand rule. Very easy. If particle is rotating in this manner, this is the direction of angular velocity. If particle is rotating in a clockwise direction, curl your fingers in that direction, the advancement of the screw will give you the direction of angular velocity. Once again, very easy. Particle is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Particle is rotating this way. Place a screw parallel to the axis of rotation. Rotate the screw in the direction of the rotation of the particle. In this particular case, particle is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. So rotate your screw in an anti-clockwise direction. The advancement of the screw, that means if I am rotating the screw this way, it will move in upward direction. So this direction will be the direction of angular velocity. Right? So for our case, in our case, omega is in upward direction. This is how. Now suppose this is the axis which is perpendicular to the plane. Now let us say that the particle is rotating in this manner. That is, the particle is now rotating in clockwise direction. No problem. Place a screw parallel to the axis of rotation. Rotate the screw in the same direction as the particle is rotating. So particle is rotating this way, so rotate the screw. So if you are rotating this way, the advancement of the screw will be in downward direction, right? Advancement will be in downward direction, so omega will be in downward direction. Clear? So this is how we will find the direction of angular velocity. Or then very easy manner, if the body is rotating this way, this will be the direction. If the body is rotating in this manner, this will be the direction. Clear? So this is how we will find the direction of angular velocity. Now okay, angular acceleration. Or beforehand, we'll do one thing. Before starting this topic, let us find the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Okay, relation between, or I'll write scalar relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Scalar relation means you just have to relate their magnitudes, right? We don't have to consider the direction here. Of course, both velocities are vector. Linear velocity is also a vector quantity, angular velocity is also a vector quantity, but here we are just removing the relation between their magnitudes. That means simply between linear speed and angular speed. Yes, of course, the magnitude of angular velocity, this is known as angular speed. Just in the case of linear, we had seen this magnitude of linear velocity is less or equals to linear speed, right? In the same manner, magnitude of angular velocity is equals to angular speed. Okay, so now let us discuss what is the relation between linear speed and angular speed. See, same diagram. Let at t equals to 0 the particle be at this point. This is the center. Particle P is at this point at t equals to 0. After any time t, let the particle be here at any time t. So what will be the angular displacement of the particle? Theta. That is delta theta, but initial angular position is 0 because we have started from 0 degree. Let r be the radius of the circle. Okay. So what is linear speed according to the definition? Linear speed is, average linear speed is distance travelled upon time taken. Speed is distance by time. Okay. So what is the distance travelled by the particle? Distance travelled by the particle is AB, which is r. This is rkb. Right? So instead of distance, I can write it as arc AB upon, let this be average velocity, time is t, or you can say delta t, there is no problem, delta t. Okay, now from the definition, arc is equals to angle into radius. Arc is equals to angle into radius. So RKB, let this angle be delta theta. It is okay if you are marking as theta or delta theta, no problem, because your initial angle is 0, initial angular position is 0. Okay, so RKB will be angle into radius upon delta t. Angle into radius, R, which is equals to angle into radius. So angle is delta theta, into radius is capital R. Okay, capital R. But what is delta theta by delta t? Omega. So finally, average speed is equals to angular speed into r. This is just the scalar relation we cannot directly use this equation because both velocities are vector quantity and we have just related their magnitudes. We have not considered the direction. Clear? This is a scalar relation between linear speed and angular speed. I am not talking about velocity, I am talking about speed. Clear? This is linear speed, which is equals to omega into r. Okay, now how to find the vector relation between linear speed and angular speed? This was all about the scalar relation. Scalar relation, that means how their magnitudes are related with each other. This is how we will find v equals to omega r. Now scalar relation, clear? Scalar relation is v equals to omega r. Now we'll understand by taking the vector form of both the velocities. That is vector relation between linear speed and angular speed, or simply relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. Okay, see, of course, the direction will come to know with the help of right hand screw rule, there is no doubt. Suppose any particle is rotating in an anti-clockwise direction, so omega will be an upward direction. We had seen that if body is moving in anti-clockwise direction, omega will be in this direction. Okay. Now particle is here, this is the center. This will be r. R, you can consider the position of the particle from the origin or from the center. From this center, r will be the position of this particle. Clear? Okay. So we had already seen in circular motion that when particle is performing circular motion, uniform circular motion, the direction of velocity is always tangential. That means at this particular point, the direction of velocity will be this way. When the particle reaches over here, the direction will be this way. When the particle reaches here, the direction will be this way. So direction of linear velocity will be tangent. Clear? Direction of velocity will be this way, going into the plane of the ball. Once again, the particle is rotating this way. Particle is rotating this way. So this is your direction of omega. This is r, and this is the direction of v. Clear? We'll understand it by taking one example. See. So we'll understand. You'll understand with this example in a better way. Suppose the body is rotating this way. This is the body is rotating in this direction. So of course, if the body is, or if particle is rotating in an anticlockwise direction, this is the direction of omega. So omega is in this direction, upward direction. This is omega, right? This is omega. Now this is r, this is r, right? Body is moving, or the particle is moving in anticlockwise direction, this way. This is how it is rotating. So this will be omega, this will be r, right? And this will be the linear velocity, direction of linear velocity. That means, once again, this is omega, this is r radius, this is r radius, and particle is here, right? So velocity v is in this direction, this way. This is v, this is r, this is omega. Clear? See. So this is what I am trying to say. This is omega in this direction. This is r, right? And this is v. See, all are perpendicular to each other. This is omega, this is r, this is v. Particle is rotating this way. Particle is rotating this way. This way. So this is v. Clear? So this is finally omega. This is r, and this will be the direction of, I mean, this is the direction of v. So what if I am using A cross B? Already we discussed in the chapter vector. A cross B, cross product of two vector, A and B. It will always give a vector quantity. So let us have omega cross r. This is your omega. This is r. Omega, with the help of right hand rule, omega cross r. Just as you had already done this in the chapter vector A cross B. So this is your omega. Place your right hand, right? Put your fingers parallel to omega and turn these fingers, or put your fingers, turn these fingers in the direction of r. This way. This way. This is omega. This is r. Omega cross r. Omega cross r. Omega cross r. This way. Omega cross r. So when you are doing omega cross r, so now you will have to rotate this way. So the advancement of the screw will be in this direction. Omega, once again, this is omega, this is r, omega cross r, omega cross r. So rotate, now imagine that you are rotating the screw in this direction, this way. So if you are rotating this way, advancement of the screw will be in this direction. So that is the same direction as that of b. If we are having a cross b, we'll get the direction of third vector. Right? So if we are doing omega cross r, whenever we are doing omega cross r, right? Omega cross r. In this case, omega cross r comes out to be in this direction. This is the same direction as that of v. So vector form will be v is equals to omega cross r. Is it clear? This is the correct equation, or this is the vector relation between linear speed and angular speed. V is equals to omega cross r. Clear? V is equals to omega r. This is what we had seen previously, but this is the scalar relation. Scalar relation. This is how their magnitudes are related, and this is how they are related with direction. You cannot write r cross omega as v. No, this is wrong, because a cross b is never equals to b cross a. Right? So this is the vector relation between omega and r. That is v is equals to omega cross r. Clear? Got it? And how to find the direction of angular velocity? Just place a thumb or place a screw and rotate it in the direction of rotation of the body. The advancement will give you the direction of angular velocity. Clear? Okay. Now, in the next video, we'll discuss about what is average angular acceleration, right? And instantaneous angular acceleration. What is the relation between linear and angular acceleration? And then we'll solve the questions based on these topics. Okay.